Wi-Fi. Oh.
It's maybe. Slow. It's working now, but slow. Working slow. Okay, let's see.
We are peers.
It's okay.
It's okay.
So, okay. Only you and...
No, you. Yeah. You
too. And no audience.
No, just you and me. Because if you talk...
I'm not prepared for that.
People have to see you. Otherwise, that's weird. That's why you should sit in that chair.
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes you know what it means to accept any position. So we're going to talk about the book, right? Yes?
What
about?
This book.
Oh. No, not this book. This book. You have?
No, I don't.
Don't be crazy.
那我把这个拆下来。可以可以，拿个刀拆下。
For Krishna's service, you do whatever you have to do. You break all the rules sometimes. I'll tell you a story. Can I tell you a story?
Yes.
There's a painting.
Yeah.
In Prabhupada's bed.
Oh yeah. 那给大家讲一个故事，说在 Prabhupada 他的床后面有一幅画，在墙上有一幅画。
And the devotee had to step on Prabhupada's bed to hang the painting on the wall.
那奉献姐姐呢，需要跨过帕布帕的床去把这个画挂到墙上。
So she asked permission, can I step on your bed? You shouldn't step on the spiritual master's bed.
所以那个奉献者呢就问帕布帕的说，那我可不可以踏着你的床，踩着你的床去挂你的画？ 因为通常帕布那个奉献者是不能踩着guru的床的。
Prabhupada said, for Krishna's service, you can stand on my head.
帕布帕说，如果是为了 Krishna 服务 Krishna 的话，你都可以踩在我的头上。
She doesn't like sitting higher than me, but it's for Krishna. Maybe I'll sit straight. Then we'll both be the same height. How's that? Better?
Sorry. Yeah, it's better that you look higher than me. See how we can sit.
So, do you want us to read from this?
At least you should sit in the middle, yeah.
Oh, then you have to sit closer. Doesn't matter. You want us to read?
Read this book?
Yeah.
I haven't seen this book yet, actually.
You're going to read from it.
Read which part?
Your favorite part.
Your favorite part?
Your favorite.
I haven't read this.
You're going to make a favorite part right now. Read from the beginning. And we'll talk about it. Mm-hmm. We're reading from this book. We're going to explain it.
然后我们会来做解释，那么就从第一章开始。
Then you're going to ask questions.
然后那我会来解释，然后大家可以来问问题。
Then we're going to read something about relationships, cooperation.
然后呢，我们会讲到这个关系和合作。
Also. Okay.
好。
First chapter, first verse.
First verse. This is verse.
Yeah. Quote. Okay. First quote.
Okay. 那好，第一章呢，是我不能改变弥天大皇关于真理的信念。你对某事的信仰比事实对你的影响更大。那么第一个
just one.
Well, yeah, I the whole, this one, the whole, or just, okay. 我们讨厌改变，大多数人更愿意依循守旧，即使它具有破坏性，也比做不熟悉的事情更为积极，虽然后者是容易的。
Translation?
Okay, English translation.
That's what you read?
Yes.
We hate changing?
Yes, this part. Mm-hmm. Okay, because we have a... We hate changing. Most people are more comfortable doing what's familiar, even though destructive, than doing what's unfamiliar, although constructive.
So, to be Krishna conscious, you have to change.
所以呢, 要具有 Krishna知觉, 我们需要改变。
Yes?
对不对?
In so many ways you have to change.
在很多方面, 我们都必须要改变。
From being a fool to being intelligent.
从一个傻瓜到变得聪明。
From being selfish to being selfless.
从一个自私的人变成一个无私的人。
From lust to love.
从色欲变为爱。
Yes? From envy to service.
从嫉妒到服务。
So, many people don't like to change.
那很多人其实并不喜欢改变。
Because it's a little painful.
因为呢, 会让他们觉得有点痛苦。
And many people say,
很多人说,
I can't change.
我不能改变。
When they actually mean, I don't want to change.
他们实际上的意思是说, 他不想改变。
You agree?
你们同意吗?
Yeah. So, we've been in the material world for millions of lifetimes.
我们已经在这个物质世界几百万世了。Because
we didn't want to change.
因为我们不想改变。Yes? 对不对?
Yes.
And we'll stay here for millions more if we don't want to change.
但如果我们不改变的话, 我们还得在这个物质世界待上几百万世。
So, because it's difficult to change, you need a strong reason to change.
因为改变是很不容易的, 所以我们需要一个很强有力的原因来让我们改变。
Because if you don't have to change, you probably won't.
因为如果你不是一定需要改变的话, 你就很难去改变。
You agree?
对吗?
So what's the reason?
那么到底改变的原因是什么呢?
That we want to change.
我们让我们就是必须要去改变。
Because we get to meet Krishna.
因为我们需要去见 Krishna.
We get to love Krishna.
我们需要去爱 Krishna.
And the more you want that,
你越是想要这一点的话,
the easier it is to change.
那么你就越有动力去改变。
And the more you want that, the less you'll say, I can't change.
你越是想要去接近 Krishna, 想要爱 Krishna, 你就越不会说我不想改变。
And the less you want it, the more you'll say, I can't change.
你越是不想去接近 Krishna, 不想爱 Krishna, 你就会越说我不想改变。
Now there's another principle.
那么还有另外一个原则。
That if you want to make something better,
如果你想让什么事情变得更好的话,
you can't just make it better unless you become better.
那只有当你变得更好的时候, 你才能让这个事情变得更好。
Sometimes we try to make it better, but we don't try to make ourselves better.
有的时候我们想把事情做得更好, 但是我们并没有让我们自己变得更好。
Because it seems easier just to work on matter.
因为就做事情看起来好像更容易一点。
Without working on ourselves.
比改变我们自己, 改善我们自己更容易。
That's why sometimes we try to improve something outside, but we fail.
这就是为什么我们有时候经常努力地去改变外在的东西, 但是往往都不成功。
Because we're not improving inside.
因为我们在内在没有改变, 没有改进。
Yes?
对吗?
So whatever is on the inside shows up on the outside.
所以我们内在有什么, 它都会展现在外在。
Well, sometimes you can fake it for a while.
当然有的时候你可以假装一下。
But eventually, it won't work.
但最终这是不行的。
Yes?
Too much.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Sometimes,
有的时候,
you may not be able to change the inside.
你可能不能改变你的内在.
So what you do is change how you act.
那么你所做的就是把你的行为方式改变了。
So let's say I'm not humble.
比如说我不够谦卑。
And I want to be humble.
我想变得谦卑。
So what do I do?
那我怎么办呢?
I'm not humble.
我不够谦卑。
I'm a very proud person.
我是个很骄傲的人。
Very arrogant.
非常傲慢。
I think I'm better than everybody.
我觉得我比所有人都好。
But then my spiritual master says, be humble.
但是我的灵性导师跟我说, 你要谦卑。
What do I do?
那我该怎么办呢?
And I say, Guru Maharaj, I'm not humble. I can't be humble.
那我会说, 亲爱的灵性导师, 我不能做不到谦卑。
Then Guru Maharaj says, well, at least act like you're humble.
那Guru会说, 至少你在行为上看起来是谦卑的, 让自己看起来谦卑。
You can't be humble, at least act like it.
所以你不能谦卑, 那么至少你在行为上要显得谦卑。
That's where it starts.
这就是我们的开始。
Because if you say, well, right now, I'm very conditioned.
你会说我现在目前的这个状态我是很受限制的。
So it will be difficult to be really humble.
所以要变得谦卑真的是很难。
So you begin by acting humble.
那么你从哪里开始呢? 就从你的行动显得谦卑开始。
Before you become humble.
那慢慢的你才会变得真正谦卑。
And that helps you become humble.
这也会帮助你变得谦卑。
As some people might say, I'm not humble and I'm waiting to become humble.
有些人会说, 我现在不够谦卑, 我在等着自己变得谦卑。
And someday in the future, I will become humble.
也许在未来的某一天, 我会变得谦卑。
And then I will act humble.
然后呢, 我就会在行动上, 就会表现出谦卑来。
Until then, I won't be humble.
但是在那个之前的话, 我是没办法谦卑的。
What do you think of that?
你们怎么看呢?
Do you like that idea?
你们喜欢这个说法吗?
Mm-hmm.
这是个谎言,
这是... yeah. It's an excuse.
这是一种借口。
Okay, I may not be humble.
是的, 我可能不够谦卑。
But I should act humble.
但是我应该在行为上
before I become
表现出谦卑来,
humble.
最后才能变得谦卑。
Yeah. Or whatever it is that I'm trying to achieve, then I should act that way.
那我如果我希望去达到谦卑的话, 那么我应该在行动上让自己慢慢的谦卑起来。
And if you act humbly, you know what happens?
如果你在行动上变得谦卑的话, 会怎么样呢?
Who would like to guess what happens?
大家可以猜一猜会发生什么?
谁愿意来猜一猜? Who would like to take a wild guess what would happen if you act humbly?
大家可以大胆的去想象一下会发生什么? 如果你在行为上 做得谦卑的话, 会发生什么? My heart will change.
Yes, very good answer.
非常好的答案。
Thank you. 谢谢。 Best answer, yeah.
这是最好的答案。
If you act like you're supposed to be, your heart will change.
如果你呢, 你在行动上, 就是让自己变得谦卑的话, 那么你的内心也会发生改变。
If I don't like you,
如果我不喜欢你,
but I'm nice to you,
但是我对你, 对你很好,
I'll start to like you.
我会慢慢地变得喜欢你。
Amazing.
很奇妙,对吗?
If I'm envious of you,
如果我对你很嫉妒,
and I serve you,
但是我服务你,
somehow I'll stop being envious of you.
那我慢慢地就会停止对你的嫉妒。
Sometimes, if you serve, if you're hungry and you serve prasadam, you're not hungry anymore.
那有的时候，当我们饿的时候，我们饿着的时候去派发prasadam，那你会觉得不太饿了。
Or sometimes, if you cook prasadam, then you're not hungry anymore.
还有的时候，当你准备去这烹饪prasadam的时候，你也不会再觉得饥饿。
Amazing.
真的很奇妙, 对吗?
You want us to read something on cooperation or relationships?
Yes.
你想不想给大家读一读这关于关系和合作的那个部分?
To find the chapter. You know the chapter?
你知道是, 21 is wonderful relationship. 21?
Okay.
Chapter 21.
Chapter 21. What page is that in your book?
121. 121. Coincidence.
My book is 145. Okay. This is a smaller book.
Oh, no. It's 115. Yeah. You want me to read?
Okay. I'll read first in English for the... Relationships are everything in life. What is the use of wealth, power, success, or practically anything in life if we have no one to share them with? Buried beneath every emotion, every thought, and every action is our most fundamental need, the desire to love and be loved.
关系是生活中的一切。如果我们没有人可以分享，那么财富、权力、 成功，人生中的万事万物都有什么用呢？ 每一种情感、想法和行为之下，都埋藏着我们最基本的需求， 那就是爱与被爱的愿望。
So, the problem is,
但问题是,
that the desire to love becomes perverted and it turns into lust.
那我们那种想去爱的愿望变成了一种色欲，它是一种扭曲的，扭曲成了色欲。So
behind the lust is the desire to love.
其实在这个扭曲的色欲之后，是我们潜藏着的对爱的这种愿望。That
means behind every action there's a desire to find love.
其实在每一个行为背后都显示着我们有爱的愿望。Now,
Bhaktivinoda Thakur said something I find so, you could say profound.
在 Bhaktivinoda Thakur, 他有一句话我觉得是非常深刻的。And
he said, women, wine, meat, don't bestow any love on you.
他说呢, 这个女人, 酒, 还有肉，它不会给你带来爱。They
don't give you love, do they?
他们不会给你爱。So
what he's saying is that we're looking for love, but matter doesn't give us love.
那也就是说我们在寻找爱，但是这些物质并不能给到我们爱。Right? 为什么？
You buy a nice car.
你买一辆很漂亮的车。
I heard in China, people are going crazy for nice cars.
我知道在中国，人们对很疯狂的都想拥有一辆很好的车。
True? Yes. But you're going to have a nice car, but there's no love.
你会拥有一辆很豪华的车，但是那里面没有爱。
You might say, I love my car.
你可能会说我爱我的车。
But it doesn't bestow love on you.
但是车并不能给到你爱。
You don't have a relationship of love with your car.
你和你的车之间没有爱的关系。
You can't fulfill that need.
你不能满足你的爱的需要。So
we're looking for love.
所以我们在寻找爱。
And there's no love in matter.
但是在物质当中我们找不到爱。Yes? 对吗?
But the problem is,
问题是,
we're looking for that love we have with Krishna.
我们在寻找对 Krishna 的爱,
and you can't find it here.
但我们在这里是找不到的。
So that's the motive behind it. Everything we're doing to find happiness, the motive behind it is to find love.
所以我们在做所有事情的这个后面的动机都是想去寻找爱。
To be loved and to give love.
希望被爱和给予爱。
That happens perfectly with Krishna.
而在 Krishna 那里，我们这一切会得到完美。
You think anyone can love you as much as Krishna?
你觉得任何一个人可以像 Krishna 对你那么爱吗？那么爱你吗？
Not even your mother can love you as much as Krishna.
就连你的母亲也不能像 Krishna 那样那么爱你。
So we want to love and we want to be loved.
所以我们想去爱和被爱。
Until we find that, we'll always be looking for it somewhere.
在我们找到这个爱之前，我们会四处去寻找，在其他的地方去寻找。
Correct?
是不是？
How do you say? Correct.
正确吗？ Correct. 正确。对吗 ？Yeah.
Tena.
对对 ，Yes or no? 对
对
对
对
对
对。
Yes, yes.
对对
对。
That means correct.
Yes, means yes.
Yes.
Yeah, all correct.
对对对。
Yeah, 对
对。I was thinking, I was writing something. I'm working on a book.
我正最近呢正在写一本书。
To present Krishna consciousness to people in general.
去向这些普罗大众们去呈现 Krishna 直觉。
In a way they can relate to it very easily.
用一种方式呢让他们能够把 Krishna 直觉和他们的生活很容易的结合到一起。
So I was giving an example this morning.
所以我今天早上呢给了一个例子。写作的时候举了一个例子。
Imagine.You had a disease.
假如说你有得了病了。
And the more you ate, the hungrier you became.
这个病呢是让你吃的越多呢，你越觉得饥饿。
You're trying to satisfy your appetite, but the more you eat, the more hungry you become.
你想努力的去满足你的胃口，但是你吃的越多，你又觉得越饿。
That would be very difficult.
所以这个是很难的。
It's like the example we sometimes give. You have an itch.
就像我们手上，比如说有点痒。
The more you scratch.
你越是去刮它。
The more it itches.
它就越痒，越抓它越痒。
You can't satisfy it by scratching it.
你通过抓它是不能够解除这个痒的。
So imagine you're eating.
所以就想象当你吃东西的时候。
You're eating for an hour and now you're starving.
你吃了一个小时了，然后可是你还是觉得很饿。
You probably go crazy.
你这样肯定会疯掉的。
Or just stop eating.
或者你也可能会就不吃了。
Yes.
对吗
？Somebody saying, "No, that'd be good. I could eat prasadam all day."
那也有人会说啊，那我这样可以一整天都在吃 prasadam， 反正也不会撑到，一直吃。
Might go crazy, but might. I mean, you might get sick. But material life is like that.
而物质生活就是这样的，就像这样。
The more you have,
你有的越拥有的越多
the more you want,
你就越想要的越多
because you're looking for love and matter.
因为你在从这个物质当中去寻找爱
and you can't find love and matter.
但是你不能从物质当中找到爱
but you think you can find what you want and matter.
但是你认为你能够在物质当中找到爱
so you get one car.
所以你有了一辆车
and you get a better car.
然后你又有一个更好的车。
So now you have two cars.
现在我有两辆车了。
Still it doesn't work.
但还是让我感觉不到爱。
So you get a bigger apartment.
然后你就得到了一座更大的房子。
And you get a second apartment if you have enough money.
如果你有足够的钱的话，你甚至能弄两套房子。
Yes, you go on like that.
然后你就不断的去想得到更多物质。
It's just like eating and you're getting more hungry.
这就像吃东西，你吃的越多，你越饿一样。
Because you want that relationship with Krishna.
因为你想要和 Krishna 的那种关系。
Yes.
对吗？
Now I just read something from Bhakti Tirtha Swami this morning.
今天早上呢，我从 Bhakti Tirtha Swami 那里读到了一点文字。
He said, if you have a relationship,
如果你有一段关系
，you should love the other person more than they love you.
你应该爱对方超过对方爱你。
Difficult, isn't it?
这有点难，对吗？你爱对方应该比他爱你更多。
We all want to be loved.
我们都想得到爱，被爱。
I won't love you if you don't love me.
如果我你不爱我的话，我不能爱你。
You don't give me anything, I won't give you anything.
如果你不给我什么东西的话，那我也不给你东西。
Well, it's a business.
这就是一种交易，对吗
？I'll make the money. You clean the house. You take care of the kids. You make the dinner.
那我去出去赚钱，那么你就在家里照顾孩子呀，料理家务呀，做晚饭啊。
And one day your husband comes home and says, I quit my job, no more money.
但有一天你丈夫回到家说我辞了工作了现在没钱了。
You may not feel loved anymore.
这个时候你是不是感觉到你们得不到爱了没有被爱了
And then you say, if you don't make money, I refuse to cook.
如果你不赚钱那我也不做饭了。
So we don't want a relationship like that.
所以我们并不想要我们的关系是这样的，对吗
？But often it ends up like that.
但是通常最后结果就是这样的。
嗯。And we don't realize that we're happier giving.
我们还没有意识到，当我们去给予的时候，我们是更快乐的。
We're never happy taking more than's given to us.
我们从就是当我们去从别人那里得到东西的时候
taking more than we give back.
当我们拿到的比我们给出去的更多的时候，我们并不一定会快乐的。
We always have to give more than we get.
我们需要永远是给的更多，拿的更少。
Just like Prabhupada.
这就像帕布帕德一样。
He was given so much.
他给予了那么多。
But he gave more than he was given.Gave more back than we all gave him.
那其实他我们给到他的，但是他回报我们的其实更多。
He was always giving.
他永远都是在给予。
We were always giving him, but he was giving us more.
我们始终在给予他，但是他给予我们的更多。
Yes.
是不是？
Should we read another one?
Which one? The second one?
I'll read it. This is called the essence of all relationships. The essence of all relationship skills is simple, profound, and not always easy to do. Be nice.
关系的实质。所有关系技巧的实质都很简单又深刻，然而并非总是容易做到，那就是友善。
Yes. Sometimes to be nice is the most difficult thing.
有的时候就做到友善就是非常难的。
It's very easy not to be nice.
其实如果不友善是很容易做到的，对吗？
Anyone have any trouble not being nice?
有人就是说对别人不友善有困难吗？就是
Somebody's not nice to you. Very easy not to be nice to them.
如果当一个人对你不友善的时候，对你来说，你很容易就对别人也不友善，对吧
？Yes. Yeah. Anybody can do it.
这个每个人都能做到。
But to be nice, that's not so easy.
但是要友善的话就不太容易了。
Sometimes you don't feel like being nice.
有的时候你就不想那么友善。
And sometimes someone's not nice to you, so you don't want to be nice to them.
有的时候别人对你不友善，那你也不想对别人友善。
And then sometimes we do something stupid.
有的时候我们做了一些愚蠢的事情。
We get mad at someone else.
我们对别人发火。
Because we want them to be nice.
因为我们想让他们对我们好。
And they're not nice.
而他们没有对我们好
so we get mad at them,
所以我们就对他们很生气
hoping they'll be nice to us.
希望他们能对我们好一点
Why aren't you nice to me?
为什么你对我 不好啊
You should be nice.
你应该对我很友善
Yes? The problem is we always think about ourselves.
但问题是，就是我们总是想着我们自己。
Yes?
是不是？
So sometimes it's difficult to be nice.
所以有的时候要做到友善很不容易。
Hmm? You know why?
你们知道为什么吗？
Should I tell you?
我要告诉你们吗？
It's a very simple reason.
非常简单的原因。
There's a few simple reasons.
有几个简单的原因。
But one reason is,
但其中一个，
if somebody's not nice to us,
有人对我们不友好的话，
we feel hurt,
我们感觉到受伤害，
or disturbed,
或者受打扰了，
or angry,
或很愤怒。
Yes? So, if you feel disturbed, hurt, or angry, how do you act?
如果你感觉到受打扰了，生气了，那你怎么办呢？
You act disturbed, hurt, or angry, most likely.
然后你也会就是气愤，表示出愤怒，表示出受打扰了。
Yes, that's pretty simple.
这是很简单的一个。
You're hurt, so you act like a hurt person. You're angry. I made you angry, so now you act like an angry person.
所以如果我的话让你受到伤害了，那么你就会像个受伤的人一样去回应。如果我的话打扰你了，你就会像一个被打扰的人一样，或者你的话让我愤怒了，我就会对你生气。
He's making a comment.
It's live. It's live broadcast.
Yeah, millions of people are watching. No, there's only 11.
在现场直播有人回应了。
No, but you know, maybe 500 by the end of the class.
Okay. 到课堂结束的时候，有500个人看。有500个人在观看这个视频，这个直播的视频。
So, one of the best relationship skills you can develop.
所以我们可以培养的一个最好的这个发展关系的技巧。
If you feel upset,
如果你感觉到生气了，
or you feel disturbed,
或者感觉到受到打扰了，
or somebody makes you angry,
或者有人让你生气了。
Don't act disturbed. Don't act in an angry way. Don't act in an upset way.
不要用你，就是你的回应的方式，不要是让人感觉到你是受到伤害了，你是被打扰了，你生气了。
That's the trick.
这就是技巧。
Or the challenge.
当然也是比较难的一个挑战。
Because that's not right.
因为这并不对，对吗？这不是一个正确的回应方式。
Yes.Like if I say something to hurt you.
比如说我说了什么话来伤害你。
Now you're hurt.
你现在觉得伤害了，受到伤害了。
Can you act like you're not hurt?
但是你能不能表现出你好像没有受到伤害一样？
If by acting you're going to hurt other people, better you don't.
如果你就是好像受到伤害的话，这样的方式去回应的话，你也会伤害到别人。
Maybe you go home and you'll feel hurt.
也许你回到家以后感觉到受伤了。
You don't want your hurt to hurt other people.
但是你不想你受伤的这种感觉伤害到其他人。
But when we're hurt, we feel generally a need to hurt the person who hurt us.
通常我们就是觉得受到伤害的时候，我们会想我们要去把那个要去伤害那个伤害到我们的人。
Yes. Yes.
But how can I do?
Act like not hurt.
但
我们怎么样能够好像没有受伤害一样的去回应对方？
Because it's the wrong thing.
因为这是不对的，错误的。
Okay, meditate on this.
然后大家做这样的冥想。
We find out.
我们发现。
That everyone in your family is doing something illegal.
你发现你们家里面所有的人都在做一件非法的事情。
And you work for the police.
然后你呢是在警察局工作的。
And you have to have them all arrested.
然后你需要把你家人都逮捕了。
And they're going to be in prison for life, and some are going to be killed.
有些人可能会这终身监禁，或者有些人甚至会判死刑。
How would you feel?
那你怎么办呢？你该怎么去想呢？
Difficult.
很难做决定，对吧？
You don't want to do it.
你不想这样做。
You're lamenting.
你很痛苦。
You can't do it.
你做不到。
That's Arjuna.
这就是 Arjuna 的面对的困境。
Same situation.
他在同样的一个境况当中。
What did Krishna say?
那 Krishna 说了什么呢？
He said, "Don't lament."
他说你不要悲伤。
Don't act in how you feel.
不要把你的想法都表现出来。
But do what's right.
只是去做正确的事情。
It's exactly what Arjuna's going through.
这就是 Arjuna 就这样去做了。
You have cousins?
你有亲戚吗？
So imagine you have to arrest them, put them in jail.
就想象一下，你要去逮捕他们，把他们投入监狱。
They're going to get hung and killed.
他们可能会被吊死或者杀死。
How difficult is that?
这多难的一个决定。
And Krishna is saying, "Don't lament."
但 Krishna 说不要悲伤。
Just do it.
只是去做。
So he has to be able to control his feelings in order to do his dharma.
所以为了他为了去履行他的职责，他必须要学会去控制他的情绪。
Right. So we all have a dharma.
我们都有我们的职责。
To be good friends, good parents, good husbands, good wives, good mothers, fathers.
要去成为一个好朋友、好父亲、好母亲，对吗？
And sometimes in these relationships, we get upset.
但是在这些关系当中，有的时候我们会感觉到不安，或者有点不高兴。
But good friends, good parents, good lovers, and so forth, they don't yell at one another.
但是一个好的朋友、好朋友或者好夫妻之间是不能彼此大喊大叫的。
So they, despite how they feel, they have to act according to what's right.
所以即使他们内心有一些不舒心、不高兴，但是他们在行动上应该是做正确的事情。就应该好朋友就是要不能大喊大叫。
We're going to get to your comments and questions later. Don't go yet.
那一会儿我们会给你们时间来分享。
People are writing.
那现在先不要动。有人在写这个问题了。
Yeah. So you have two things.
所以有两件事情。
One is how you feel.
一个是你感觉是怎么样的。
And one is what is right.
另外一个呢是正确的做法应该是什么。
Now when you're a conditioned soul.
作为一个受限制的灵魂。
What you feel and what is right may be two different things.
就是你所想感受到的和应该去做的正确的事情可能是不一样的。
When you're a pure devotee.
当你是个纯粹的奉献者。
What you feel and what's right will be the same thing.
而作为一个纯粹奉献者，你所感受到的和正确的，可能大多数时候是同一致的。
But because the material world, is a difficult place, even for advanced devotees, sometimes they have to be very tolerant.
但是在这个物质世界，即使是那些很进步的奉献者，他有的时候也要学会去容忍的。
Like Krishna tells Arjuna, be tolerant.
所以Krishna 跟 Arjuna 说，你需要去容忍。
What does tolerance mean?
那容忍意味着什么呢？
It means I feel like doing something that I shouldn't do.
那就是说我想做一些我不想不应该去做的事情。
I just feel like giving up.
我就想放弃。
But I have to tolerate the situation.
但是我必须要去容忍一些情况。
I can't act on how I feel.
所以我不能够把我的情感通过动作表现出来。
So this discussion all began by saying in relationships we should be nice.
所以呢，我们的讨论呢，就是一直在说我们在一个关系当中应该表现的友善。
Because sometimes we don't feel like being nice.
有的时候我们就不想对别人友好。
Be nice.
你就必须要友好。
I don't feel like it.
但是我不想那样去做。
Leave me alone.
你不要管我。
Yes. So that's exactly Arjuna's position.
这就正好是 Arjuna 所处的处境。
Krishna is saying, "Don't let your feelings get in the way of your dharma."
Krishna 说不要让你的这种情感你的情绪去超越了你的宗教的职责。
I don't feel like chanting today.
我今天不想念诵。
So, I'm not going to chant.
那我就不念了。
No, can't do that.
那你不能这样做，对吧？
You have to chant.
你还是必须要念诵的。
It's the right thing.
这是正确的事情。
You know, in the scripture it says, when the husband comes home, the wife should greet him.
在经典当中说，丈夫回到家，那么妻子应该出门迎接，在门口迎接。
The big smile.
然后给他一个大大的微笑。
Very nice.
非常友好。
That doesn't always happen.
但是是，不是总会发生这样的事情，对吧？
Why are you late?
为什么你回来晚了？
Your food is cold.
你的那个饭都凉了。
It's not easy to be nice.
所以要一直友善也不太容易。
Is it?
是不是？
Yeah. But, Krishna says in the 12th chapter, a devotee is a friend to everyone.
那在 Krishna 在伯家在第十二章当中说，奉献者是所有人的朋友。
A devotee doesn't put anyone in anxiety.
奉献者呢不应该让任何人处于一种焦虑当中。
Is that okay? Now I want to tell you something else that I read that I think is very interesting and important. And then we'll get to some questions.
那我还想给大家再说两个，就是我所看到的，我觉得它很有趣，也很对大家很有价值的。
So we were talking about relationships of two people, but now I want to talk about relationships in a group.
那我刚才讲到的是两个人之间的关系，那现在我想谈一谈一个群体当中的关系。
If you take a group of people together,
那么我们现在把一些人集合到一起,
one of three things will happen.
那么三个当中有一件事情会发生, 三件事情当中有一件事情会发生。
I don't know if you've seen this, but sometimes you put a group of people together and they don't work well.
有的时候可能你们会看到有这样的情况发生, 当你把一些人放在一起的时候,
well, you've seen
他们可能合作并不太愉快。
You've seen that they don't work well.
然后你也看到了他们没有合作得很好。
But the result of that is what they accomplish is less than they're capable of accomplishing, because they don't work well together.
那你会最后结果你会看到他们因为他们没有合作得很好，所以他们所取得的结果就是没有达到他们应该达到的那个程度。
Have you seen that?
你们看到过这样的情况吗？
Like you become discouraged or. You're not enthusiastic.
比如说你就不是很起劲啊。
Because somebody is trying to control everything.
或者是有一个人想控制掌控一切啊。
Or their relationships are bad.
然后你们的关系不是太好啊。
So you're not very enthusiastic.
所以你就不是很有热情。
So even though you have this group that could do something very great, they don't do that something that great.
所以就因为有这种情况，你们这一个小组本来可以做得很好的，但是最终结果是没有做得很好。
Have you ever heard of Orville Wright?
Orville?
Right. He and his brother, they created the first airplane.
哦，那就是说你们听说过那个，就是布莱特兄弟，对吧？他们创造了第一架飞机的。
You heard of them?
Wright.
They call the Wright brothers.
A Wright brother 就是那个莱特兄弟啊。叫布莱特，莱特兄弟他们发明了第一架飞机的。
You know what their qualification was for creating an airplane?
你知道他们这个在制造飞机上有什么资格吗？就他们
They didn't have one. Their job was repairing bicycles.
其实他们没有任何制造飞机的资格，他们的工作只是去修自行车的。
Did you know that?
你们知道这一点吗？
Yeah, that was their job. They repaired bicycles.
那就是他们的工作，他们的工作就是去修自行车的。
But none of them had been to college.
而且他们没有一个人去过大学，上过大学。
They were really enthusiastic with this idea. It just got in their head that we could create a machine that flies and that would change the world.
但是呢，虽然他们没有什么教育啊，也不是坐飞机的，但是他们就有非常强烈的愿望和热情，要造出一架能够飞到天上的机器。
So they got a bunch of their friends together.
所以他们就找了很多朋友在一起。
All high school graduates, but no college.
都是高中的毕业生，
no engineering skills.
高中的同学啊什么，然后都没有什么专业的技术。
Well, they were so enthusiastic.
但他们非常有热情。
To create an airplane.
然后就这样非常有热情的投入去制造一架飞机，最后他们就成功了。
So that's the second thing that happens.
这就是第二件发生的会发生的事情。
You get people together who maybe aren't that qualified, but the enthusiasm and inspiration of the association creates a situation where they do more than they're actually capable of doing.
所以呢，就像我们把一群人聚集到一起，虽然他们每个人都不是很有资格，但是因为他们有这个共同的目标，他们就可以做到甚至超过他们能力的事情。
Now, I don't know if you know the story, but there was another group of people who were also trying to create an airplane while the Wright brothers were trying to create their airplane. So it was like a race.
那就是其实在莱特兄弟他们造飞机的同时，还有一批人他们也在造飞机。其实就像他们两拨人就像在比赛一样，看谁先造出第一架飞机来。
And they were more qualified.
而那另外一拨人呢，他们是更有资格的。
They had more money. They had support.
而且他们有更多的资金来支持他们。
The Wright brothers didn't have any money.
而莱特兄弟呢，他们是没有什么钱的。
Everything they did, everything they bought was from their work as bicycle repairmen.
他们所买的一切的这些设备都是来自于他们修自行车的。
And this other group was trying to create an airplane so they could become famous for creating an airplane.
而另外一组的人，他们制造飞机的动力来自于他们觉得我们造出飞机以后可以变得出名。
So the Wright brothers, their motives were stronger.
所以呢，莱特兄弟他们制造飞机的这个动机更强，
and the other,
动力更强。
And by the time the Wright brothers had created the airplane, the other group had not figured out how to do it.
所以在莱特兄弟造出飞机的时候，另外一组还没有造出来。
So.They were more capable, but less successful.
尽管另外一组他们其实更有能力，但是他们没有莱特兄弟更成功。
So when we come together, we're either going to be more successful than we would be individually, or possibly going to be less successful than we would be individually, or possibly we'll be the same. Nothing better, nothing worse.
I didn't quite figure out this.
When we come together to work together,By working together, we're going to be able to do something greater than we could do individually, or we're going to end up doing something less than we could do, or it'll be the same.
那就是说，当我们有作为一个集体在一起的时候，我们可能会集体出来的成果会大于我们每个人的实际的能力，也可能会低于我们每个人的实际能力，也可能就相当的。
You have that experience?
你们有这样的体会吗？
So it's interesting.
所以这点很有趣。
Because that means if we want to be successful as a group, we need to be able to work well together.
所以呢，我们如果做一个集体，想要获得成功的话，那我们就需要有非常好的合作。
Like our qualifications are only part of it.
我们的资格只是其中的一部分。
Yes?
对吗?
In English, you have the word called synergy.
在英语当中我们有一个叫合力的一个词。
And synergy usually means you put things together and they're greater than they are individually.
它的意思就是说我们把一些东西放在一起，它的这个最后的能量要大于每一个单独的能量。
But I have experience, I think we all do, of negative synergy, where you put things together and they're worse than they were individually.
但是我们常常碰到的情况是负面的。这个我们把一些人都聚集在一起之后，最后获得的能量还没有单独的每个人的能量强。
Like someone has a job and the boss won't let them be creative, so they do work below their ability.
就像一个人他在他工作单位，那么他的老板希望他就是所做的事情是他所不想要做的，所以他最后出来的成果还达不到他实际的能力。
Yes. Yeah, so that's very important.
所以这一点很重要。
And the other thing, when you work in groups,
另外一件事情
is to try to avoid the tendency of thinking whatever problem there is, it's because of somebody else.
还有一个就是我们需要避免有一种倾向，觉得出了问题一定是某其他人的问题。
You see, the biggest problem in any company or any group or any organization is us.
我们要知道，无论在什么样的机构里面，其实最大的问题都是我们自己。
So why do I say that?
我为什么要这样说呢？
Because that's how we have to think.
因为这是我们必须要考虑的。
Because we have to improve ourselves first.
我们需要首先改善我们自己。
Prabhupada said, if you don't like what someone is doing, then do what you'd like them to be doing. Then act the way you'd like them to act.
那如果说
to inspire them.
那如果你不喜欢某一个人做的事情，那么你就应该去激励他去做你想让他做的事情。
Why are you doing that?
为什么你要这么干？
That's wrong.
这不对呀。
No, I should do what I want you to do.
那我应该做我想让你做的事情。
But everybody looks for the problem somewhere else.
但是每个人呢都在别的地方去寻找问题。
Everywhere but in me.
所以就不是没有在我自己身上，其实所有的一切最后都在我自己身上。
Now, we have 20 people here.
我们这里有二十个人。
And if we all became a little better,
如果我们每个人都改善一点点，
then we'd all be 20 times better.
那我们就会二十倍的好，二十倍的变得更好，对吗？
20 times more effective.
那二十倍的更高的二十倍的效率。
But if we all think the problem is somebody else,
但如果我们都认为问题是别人的问题，
we might be totally ineffective.
那我们就会完全没有效率。
Yes, it's possible.
这是很可能的。
So they have made some comments. I have to look.
他们做了一些评论。
I have to get close.
Yeah,
hold on.
I can't see it either.
I have to go back. We're gonna go.
Didn't wear my glasses.
I am. You can't see it.
No, I have to stay very close.
It's a good time of day. Oh, she wants to know what book I'm reading.
What book are you reading?
This is my new book, which is sitting in India in English, but this is the Chinese version. That's the Chinese version, so we're reading from the Chinese version. So we're working on getting the book out of India into the rest of the world.
This book originally is printed in India?
Yeah, it's sitting in Indian storage right now.
They
just got the books and the devotee managing it went on a vacation. So amazing and so wonderful that the heart will change just by acting on the specific quality of the deed we wish to be as humility.
当我们按照我们所希望拥有的这个品质去活动的时候，我们的内心就会发生改变。比如说谦卑，当我们就是，我们就让自己的行动上显得谦卑，就通过这一点，我们也可以改变我们的内心。这个人他说这一点非常非常美妙，非常好。
That's a comment.
这是个评论。
She was appreciating that idea.
他在对咕噜的讲课表示赞赏。
Who's here? Okay, more comments. If I touch that, then it goes down. Okay. My mom used to say, two wrongs don't make a right.
No, don't, okay. 我妈妈经常说，两个错误并不能变成一个正确的。
When I told Bhaktitirtha Swami one time about how there was a strain in the relationship between his disciples and one of our god brothers,
当我告诉 Bhaktitirtha, Swami 的时候，说我的那个门徒之间有很多的，在关系上有很紧张的时候。
He said to me, "It sounds like a call for love."
他就说，这听起来好像是大家在寻求爱。
Similar to your point of complaining, because we want to be loved and reciprocated with.
这和你提到的这个就是抱怨的观点是很相似的，因为我们都想被爱，得到回报。
I want to tell you a story.
我给大家讲一个故事。
It's a nice story.
一个很好的故事。
My sister was a teacher.
我的 your younger sister or elder sister?
I only have one. My sister. She's
older.
Because
in Chinese, it's different.
Oh, older sister.
我的姐姐。我的姐姐是个老师。
And she was teaching kids from very poor backgrounds.
那么他教的孩子呢，都来自于非常贫穷的这种家庭背景。
So they had very bad parents. A lot of them had bad parents.
所以很多学生他们的父母都很不好。
They'd come to school, they would have black eyes and clothes that were smelly, like that.
那他们的父母到学校来接他们的时候，都是可能眼睛都是青的，或者身上那个衣服的味道很大。
So they had a lot of behavioral problems.
所以呢 ，you mean the kids, right?
Yeah.
所以这些孩子们有很多这种行为的上面一些障碍，行为上的问题。
My sister was talking to my mother about it.
然后我的姐姐呢就跟我妈妈讲这个事情。
So there are some kids in the class that are so bad I can't deal with them.
她说我的班上有些学生呀，那太差劲了，我实在是搞不定他们。
My mother told her.
我妈妈就跟她说。
Said the kids that are the biggest problem.
她说这孩子们是最大的问题吗
？They need the most love.
其实他们的最大问题，其实是因为他们需要爱，需要最多的爱。
So they're actually doing mischief is their call for love.
所以呢，这个它的奥秘就在于，就是说他们所反映出来的，就是他们在呼唤爱。
So then my sister, she gave them special attention.
所以呢，我的姐姐就给了这些孩子们一些特殊的关注。
Said I need you to be my special assistant to help me.
啊，她就会对有些孩子说。啊，我现在需要你的特殊的帮助来做我的助手。
So then they felt very important.
所以这样的时候呢，孩子们就会觉得自己很重要，对吗
？She said they totally changed.
然后就通过这样的方式，这些孩子们就发生了很大的改变。
So sometimes when somebody's upset,
所以有的时候如果一个人他生气了、恼火了
，It's just a sign that they're calling out for affection.
这往往就表明着他在发出的信号，表示他需要得到爱了。
But our tendency is to become angry with them.
但我们的倾向往往，我们的倾向往往是一个人他发脾气了、生气了，我们也会更生气，对吧
？So don't take it personally.
So 我们不要把这个别人跟你，比如说发脾气，看作是对你个人的什么想法，作为一个个人的行为。
I can't tell you where we are. It's top secret. Someone wants to know where we are. I don't know where we are. We're somewhere. We're in Taiwan somewhere. Okay, Pallavi Mishra. That's Guru Nishna says. That's a big challenge. Not acting or reacting to our hurt.
这个就是说是一个很大的挑战，就是，我们受伤的时候，我们就会表现出像一个受伤的人那样的去行动，对吗
？So you know, whenever you're upset, just ask yourself, what is the right way to act? Not how I feel like acting is one thing, but what's the right way to act?
所以，当我们受伤或者是被激怒了的时候，我们应该想着，不是说哎呀我们很受伤，而是我们正确的反应应该是什么？
Because the way we feel is not always the right way to act.
因为我们自己的感受往往都不一定是正确的行动的方式。
And like I was saying, if somebody upsets you, but you realize that they're just calling for love, then you may not get upset.
所以当一个人对你发脾气，你呢就认你已经意识到了他其实在向你呼唤爱，那么你就不会发脾气，就不会跟他发脾气。
And the more you love, the more tolerant you'll be.
所以你爱的越多，你就变得越来越宽容。
Yes. I'll give you an example.
我给大家讲一个例子。
Before I had children, I didn't have a child, my wife did, but before we had a child, sometimes we would see parents with children and we'd think, how is it that they're tolerating the children? Because the children, they do so many bad or wrong things.
在我们有孩子之前呢，我们看到别的父母带着孩子的时候，我们就想，哎呀，这个父母肯定要容忍孩子很多啊，因为孩子往往都会做一些坏事啊。
And if you don't have children, you might think, well, I could never tolerate this. This is too difficult.
如果没孩子的人，他会看到这个，他会想，哎呀，我肯定不能像他们这么容忍。我要是有孩子，我肯定不会像他们这么容忍的。
But later we found out the secret.
但是后来我们发现了这个秘密。
Secret is if they're your children, you can tolerate it because you love them.
秘密就是，如果是你自己的孩子，你就能容忍了，因为你爱他们。
Someone else's children say, go away, don't bother me.
但是如果是别人的孩子的话，你估计就没那么容忍了，对吧？啊，走开吧，别来打扰我了。
You think, how do you tolerate this kid? I've only been here 10 minutes. He's driving me crazy, and you live with him.
所以我看见别人那个就带着孩子，就会觉得这个实在容忍是不太可能的。你这孩子太让人就让人发疯了一样，怎么能去容忍呢？
But because you love him or her.
但是如果你爱一个孩子的话。
So you try to somehow how either see the good or some way have affection for others, and then you become less upset.
所以当你如果就对这个孩子有很多的爱的话，那么你就不会那么容易生气，会更容忍。
You know, a lot of times we judge people on how they do things.
很多时候我们都会去评价别人。他们是怎么做事情的？我们会在内心做一个评判。
A lot of people do things with good intentions, but they do them wrong.
很多人做事情呢，他的意愿是很好的，出发点是很好的，但往往最后结果是不太好的。
Like when the movement started, everybody was practically doing everything wrong, but the intention was to please Krishna, but they didn't know how.
就像我们运动开始的时候，每个人的出发点都很好的，都想去取悦 Krishna。但是他们都不知道该怎么去做。
So Prabhupada accepted the intent. He loved them because of their intention, not because of their capability.
所以帕布帕德呢，就接受门徒的这些良好的这个意愿，虽然可能做的不是很对，但是他们出发点是很好的，所以他都接受。
If you see a devotee's heart and their intention, you can love them, even though maybe externally they do things wrong.
所以奉献者呢，他也许表面上做的不太对，但是他的用心是好的。所以我们都应该接受，都应该去接受这一点。
Like somebody spends all day cooking for you.
比如有一个人，他花了一整天的时间为你做饭。
Maybe they don't cook the way exactly you like to eat.
可能他做饭做的并不是你想吃的。
But you appreciate it so much because they spent so much time cooking.
但是你内心也会充满了感激，对吗？因为他花了一整天的时间为你做饭。
It doesn't matter if you like it or not. You like it because they put so much love in it.
那其实并不，你到底喜不喜欢这个饭并不重要，对吗？就是因为他付出了爱，所以你都会喜欢的。
Like, you know, when I travel and I stay in devotees' homes, that when I leave, they always say, "Please forgive me for any offenses."
当我住在奉献者家里的时候，每次我离开的时候，奉献者都会说，啊，请您原谅我们所做的任何冒犯。
But I never see offenses because I just see they're sincerely trying to serve.
但我会说，其实我没有看到任何冒犯哦。我所看到的都是你想努力的来 做服务来取悦我。
But technically speaking, you could see offenses.
当然从技术上来讲，它确实是有冒犯的。
I stayed at one devotee's house and we went out like at 9 o'clock to some program and I said, is there any breakfast? Oh yeah, let's look. Yeah, it just completely forgot to feed me, yeah.
哦，那就像我有一次和一个奉献者出去，早上9点做节目，然后我就问他那早饭在哪儿吃，他说他就完全忘掉早饭的事情了。
Oh, you like to eat? I forgot.
啊，他说啊，你想吃东西啊？我忘了。
Anyway, I understood he was He had a lot going on, so he forgot.
所以我也能理解他脑子里肯定想了很多东西，所以忘了。
So you have to see, you have to see it on a different level.
所以你要站在不同的层面上去看。
Otherwise, you become upset.
否则的话，你就会心里不高兴。
You invite me to your house, you don't even feed me.
我在你家里面，你竟然不给我吃饭。
Yes, it happens. I was in a temple, yeah.And same thing happened, you know, it was like lunchtime and there was no lunch. There was nobody around.
Alright.
Guess we don't have lunch today.
那你就你也只能接受今天就没有。
But you know, you understand that it wasn't their intention that I starve. It was just somebody thought someone else was getting it.
Oh.可能有的时候 是有人会觉得、哦、这个饭是别人来做结果都没做。
So you try to understand.
所以就尽量的去理解了。
It's not a plot to starve me to death. Without real love for Krishna, there's no satisfaction and we stuff our life filled with trash.
如果没有这个真正对 Krishna 的爱的话就没有内心就不会得到满足。我们就内心就会充满了很多的垃圾。
Yes. I don't know if you have this experience.
不知道大家有没有这样的体会。
Do you ever have experience you're hungry?
你有经历过饥饿的感觉吗？
And you're eating something. And you don't like it.
然后或者是你吃一些你不喜欢吃的东西。
And it doesn't satisfy you?
没有让你觉得满足。
Because you're not satisfied, your instinct is to eat more.
因为你还没有得到满足，所以你的本能呢，就会再吃更多。
But it's not what you want or like, so it never satisfies you. You just keep eating and eating and you're never...
就因为这个饭呢，不是你特别喜欢吃的，所以你吃完了以后也没觉得满足。
You have that
没满足就还要再吃，再吃。
You have that experience?
你们有这样的体验吗？
Yeah, that's like...Or, let's say, you had potatoes for breakfast.
比如说今天早饭吃的是土豆。
And you have potatoes for lunch.
然后午饭也是土豆。
And you came to my house for dinner.
然后你到我家里来吃晚饭。
And I gave you the same potatoes that you had for breakfast and lunch.
然后我给到你的是你早餐所吃的土豆。
It's not really going to satisfy you, no matter how much you eat.
所以就即使你吃的很多，你还是觉得内心不满足，
right?
对吧？
So that's trying to satisfy yourself with material things is like that.
所以想要尽量的去满足你的物质欲望的话，结果就是这样，永远都不会满足。
So we have Raj Lakshmi from Taiwan is commenting. Do not act on the negativity is really the great critical turning point for our better going on with life. At least avoiding direct friction and...Let me get rid of this. I have to go back and find it. At least avoiding direct friction, and which helps and ease the later communication on mending the relationship, although it might be very painful and difficult. At least no direct friction at face.
Mm.那么也就是刚才顾所讲到的这个人他评论说非常好的这一点就是讲到我们不应该用一种负面的方式去反应去做出回应这是真的是我们在就改善我们自己的这个过程当中一个非常重要的一个转折点就是从这里开始我们不要以负面的这种情绪啊什么去反做出回应至少不要有直接的冲突这样的话会帮助我们更好的去和别人交流或者是改善我们的关系。尽管这个是做起来是很痛苦很难的。
You finish?
但至少在表面上不要有直接的冲突摩擦。
Do the right thing, at least we will be at peace, our heart in peace.、Yeah.
所以要做正确的事情。这样的话我们内心就会平和。
Like sometimes,
我们的内心
You do the right thing.
所以就是要去做正确的事情。
And the other person is still angry.
如果你做正确的事情，对方还在生气的话。
Or you don't get the result, the best result.
或者你没有得到最好的结果。
Could have got a better result doing the wrong thing.
如果你做错的事情，可能会得到更好的结果。
But you feel good that you've done the right thing.
如果你做了正确的事情的话，你自己会感觉更好。
It's a really interesting concept.
这是一个真的是一个非常有趣的
of happiness.
一个概念，关于幸福的快乐的一个概念。
And feeling good about yourself.
让你自己感觉到很好。
Like some people will say, you should feel good about yourself.
就像有人说，你应该对自己感觉良好。
Because that's healthy.
因为这是一种很健康的想法。
If you feel bad about yourself, you're just depressed. You can't do anything.
但如果你要是感觉自我感觉很不好的话，你就会好像很压抑啊，很沮丧。
But you shouldn't do the wrong thing and feel good about yourself.
但是你不应该做错误的事情还感觉很好。
That's like taking drugs.
那就像这个就是吸毒一样。
You do whatever you want, but you'll feel good.
或者像喝酒一样。你做的都是错误的事情，但是自己感觉还挺好。
We should feel good doing the right thing.
你应该在做正确的事情的时候感觉很良好。
We should feel good because we do the right thing.
或者是我们感觉良好，是因为我们做了正确的事情。
Not just because we're supposed to feel good.
而不是我们应该感觉到良好。
Right? Yeah. So some people will say feel good, but they won't say do good to feel good. They'll just say feel good, and that's wrong.
所以有的人会说你要感觉良好，他没有说你应该做好的事情让自己感觉良好。
You understand?
你都明白吗
？Interesting, isn't it? What is the name of the book? Uplift yourself, change the world. They're asking the name of the book.
啊、哦，他们在问这本书是什么名字
The ideas.We can only make the world better if we get better.
所以我想说的就是，我们想让这个世界变得更好，那么就必须让我们自己变得更好。
So first, I become better.
就首先我自己变得更好。
Then I can make you better.
然后我才能够让你变得更好。
You know, we make a mistake.
我们常常会犯一个错误。
We think, in order to help people, I need to know more.
为了去帮助别人，我需要了解更多。
Well, you need to know, yes.
当然你也需要知道。
But what you know is not as important as who you are.
但是你所知道的并不如你到底是谁更重要。
Because you have to model what you teach.
因为呢你需要就是你教别人东西的话你需要做一个示范的你要做一个给人家做一个例子。
If I don't model what I teach, no one will believe that it's possible to do it.
所以如果我不是以自己的以身作则的话那我就没别人是没办法相信你所教导的东西。
Like I tell you, you should be nice even when you've been hurt.
比如说我跟你说就算你别人伤害了你你也应该表现得很友好。
Then you might think, that's impossible.
然后你可能会说不可能。
And then you say something to me.
然后你会看我身上发生了一些事情。
That's impossible. And you tell me it's impossible.
你跟我说这是不可能的。
And I get angry.
然后我的生气。
It is too possible.
它是可能的。
And then you realize it's not possible because I can't even do it.
然后你就会意识到，这肯定是不可能的，因为就连我也做不到，对吧
？You understand?
明白吗
？So, but if I can do it, then you'll think, oh, it's possible because he's doing it.
嗯，如果我能做到的话，哦，你就想，哦，这是有可能的，因为我都能做到，那你也能做到。
So it doesn't matter what you say. If you can't follow it, no one will believe it.
所以这你说什么并不重要。如果你能做到的话，别人才会相信你。
Does that make sense?
这样有道理吗
？Be humble.
要谦卑。
Like me.
像我一样谦卑。
So now I better be humble.
所以我最好我也要谦卑。
I say be humble, and you're thinking, is he really humble, or is he just saying that?
如果我说你要谦卑，那你会想，那他是不是真的谦卑啊？
Yes.Is it realistic to think we should always blame ourselves when others have made bad managerial decisions, and we are expected to cooperate with them. Cooperation is a huge topic.
就说我们当就说当其他人做了一个就是错误的管理上的决定的时候，我们是不是应该总是责备我们自己？我们应该做更合，就应该合作，有更好的合作，这种想法现不现实？就是管别人的做了一些管理上的错误的决定，那最后可能结果不好，那我们去埋怨我们自己，说哎，这是我们的问题，这样的想法是不是现实的？
This is a sensitive question.
这是一个很敏感的问题。
Because what he's saying is sometimes someone else actually makes a mistake.
那他其实是想说有的时候是其实是别人做出了一个错误。
So if you make a mistake,
如果你犯了错误，
why should I blame myself?
那我为什么要责备我自己呢？
We have to correct you.
我们要更正你才对啊。
Right? So, Prabhupada once said,If anything is at fault, you should think it's my fault.
Prabhupada 曾经说，如果有事情有错误发生的话，你应该想的是你的问题。
So the way I understood it was, at least you should fix it.
至少对我的，在我理解的就是，我们应该去搞定它。
Maybe it's not really my fault.
也许不是我的错误，但是我应该去把这个事情解决了。
But right now I'm looking. Let's say.Somebody's injured in an accident.
比如说一个人在一场事故当中受伤了。
And they need help.
他们需要帮助。
Well, it's not my fault.
当然我会说这不是我的错。
Get the guy who ran into you to help you. I have things to do.
那个人撞了你的人他应该来帮助你。那我和我没关系的，那我还有我自己的事情要做呢。
So in the sense that now you're there seeing the problem, it becomes your problem.
但当时因为你正好在场，你看到了这场事故，那么这就成了你的问题了。
In other words, could I do something now to make it better?
所以换一个说法，就是我当时在那里，那我是不是能做什么来让事情变得更好？
There's a story.
有一个故事。
Very nice story.
非常好的一个故事。
I'll tell you next year.
我明年再告诉你们。
Do you want to hear the story? It's really nice.
你们想听到这个故事吗？
So, in Los Angeles, we had an art department.
我们在洛杉矶呢有一个艺术的部门。
And they were painting all the, they were doing all the paintings for all of Prabhupada's books.
他们呢是在为这个帕布帕德的书籍做那个绘插图的。
And they had so many paintings in the temple.
那么他们那个庙里有很多很多的画。
They didn't have walls.They already hung all the paintings on the walls. There weren't enough walls to hang the paintings.
他们已把画全部都挂在墙上了，墙已经没有地方给他们再挂画了。
So one painting was on the floor.
所以有一幅画呢就在地上。
In the pujari room.
在 pujari 的这个房间里面。
So anything which is sacred should not go on the floor.
所有神圣的东西都不应该放在地上的。
So Prabhupada was taking a tour, and he was walking through the pujari room, and he saw the painting on the floor.
所以当时帕布帕德他在巡视的时候，到了普加瑞的房间，就看见地上躺了这幅画。
So Prabhupada was with his servant, and his servant travels with him all over the world.
那帕布帕德当时在这个世界整个旅行的时候，一直带着一个仆人。
So Prabhupada said, "Who put this painting on the floor?"
帕布帕德就说，谁把这幅画放在地上了
？And the servant said.I don't know, Prabhupada. It's not my responsibility.
那仆人就说：“我不知道，帕布帕，这不是我的职责。”
And Prabhupada said, "It is too your responsibility."
他说：“那帕布帕就说，这就是你的职责。”
What did he mean?
他是什么意思呢？
He means you're looking at it right now, and it's on the floor. Do something.
他说：“你现在既然已经看见这幅画在地上了，那么你应该做一点事情。”
No, Prabhupada, I didn't put it on the floor.
他说：“不，那仆人说不是我放在地上的。”
But right now, it's your fault that it's still on the floor.
那帕布帕德说：“但是现在就是你的错了，因为它还躺在地上。”
You understand? So in that sense, we could say it's my fault.
从那个意义上来讲，这就是我的错。你看见他没有去改变他。
I think Prabhupada's sense was, it's not my fault if someone else did something wrong.But if I don't do anything to make it better, or if I could have done something to prevent it, then it's my fault.
所以帕布帕德的意思呢，就是说，即使这个事情不是我做的，这个错不是我犯的，是别人犯的，但是如果我能够让它变得更好的话，就应该去做。
Yes. Right. So if there are many problems in the world, if I can be better, the world will be better. So those problems indirectly are my fault.
所以这个世界上有很多的问题，如果我不改善我自己，就如果我改善我自己的话，我就可以让这些问题变得更好一点。所以从这个意义上来讲，所有的问题其实都是我的问题。
You probably know that your country is growing so fast.
你们可能知道，你们的国家现在在发展的非常快。That
you may contribute more to the ecological problems of the world than the United States has contributed, because you have more people.
因为你们有很多的人，所以你们每个人能够。 对这个整个世界的这种生态环境做出更大的贡献，甚至超过比联合国还要能够做更大的贡献。
We have 300 million people. You have a billion, right? How many? 1.2?
1.3 billion, I guess. So you 我们有三亿人，你们有十三、十四亿人。
Maybe you have four times. Maybe we have about four times more people than America.
对，你们的人口人数是美国的四倍了，对吧？
So if you live on the standard of Americans, then you'll be taking four times more resources, four times more pollution, etc.
所以如果你们按照美国人的生活标准的话，那么你们会占用四倍的资源。
So I'm an American. I don't walk around thinking, oh, I'm polluting the earth.
那我是个美国人，我不会说，哎呀，我现在在污染整个地球。
And you're Chinese people, you don't think, oh, you know, when you get on a bus, I'm such a bad person, I'm riding a bus, I'm polluting the earth. We don't think that way, but we are.
我们比如说坐到公共汽车上，我们不会想着我们现在在乘公共汽车，我们在污染这个环境，你不会这样去想。Yes?
Every time we buy something we don't need, we're contributing in some way to unnecessary exploitation of the earth.
有的时候我们去买了一些我们并不是很需要的东西，对吗？ 那其实我们就是在剥削这个地球的资源。
You buy an electric car, more pollution was created making that car than you're going to save by driving it.
当你买了一个电车的时候，你可能开这个电车所给这个地球带来的污染，会多于你骑自行车，对吗？
So in that sense, you know, I'm responsible.
所以在那个意义上来讲，我都是有责任的。
In some way.
在某种意义上来讲。
Although it doesn't seem like it.
虽然看起来不是这样。
So is all the ecological problems of the world my fault?
所以所有的这个生态的问题都是我的问题吗? 我的错误吗?
We can't say that, but if I have a smaller carbon footprint, you know, carbon footprint?
No,
that's it, I guess an American saying. If I utilize less resources, there'll be less pollution.
当然我们可以说这整个这个生态环境不是我们个人的过错，但是如果我们每个人用少一点资源的话， 我们就可以就改善一点这个地球的环境。
I once saw, whoops, he goes on to say, whoops, we lost it. Gauradas, we lost you. Huge topic. I once saw a bumper sticker. It said, I'm a very cooperative person. As long as you see things my way, we'll get along just fine in dealing with authority. Oh, we'll get along just fine. You understand? That's a joke. I saw a bumper sticker that said, I'm a very cooperative person. As long as you see things my way, we'll get along just fine.
我是一个非常善于合作的人，我是很合作的人。只要你们看到这个事情符合我的想法，那我就会表现得很好，很配合。
You understand?
就很符合，很配合。
We get along fine. Yeah, just do whatever I say, we'll get along fine.
You mean if things are in our way?
You do it my way.
In my way, so I'll
be fine. You and I will get along just fine. Just do whatever I tell you.
就是说，当别人都听我的，都是按照我的想法去做的时候，那我就肯定很好了，很配合，对吧？
So he's making the point that if you're a leader, you have to cooperate. You can't just say, cooperate with me, but you have to cooperate. It has to go both ways.
这就是说，当我们做一个领导者的时候，我们不能总说，哎，你要跟我配合。有的时候，你也要去配合其他的人。And
in the end, the love you take is equal to the love you make.
Yeah, 到最，其实最终说来，你所得到的爱和你所给予的爱是相同的。
You give love, you get love.
对你，当你给予爱的时候，你就得到爱。
That was from the Beatles song.
那是是不是那个甲壳虫的一首歌呀
？Are the Beatles illegal in China?
No, no.
Did they?
甲壳虫在中国是不非法的，是吧
？Not illegal.
Not illegal.
Used to be.
No, not even.
Okay, that's a Beatles song.
这是一个甲壳虫的歌，就是你得到。你给予多少爱，你就得到多少爱。
Sometimes the devotees quote the Beatles' Purana because they have some good songs.
有的时候枫叶姐会去引用这个甲壳虫当中的一些歌，因为它里面有些歌词是很好的，也很符合我们的想法的。
So, it's very hard for me not to get angry, and I really don't like it. How can I be more lovely?
就是有的时候要不跟别人生气，对我来说是蛮难的。我怎么才能够，就是对每个人都很友好
？I could give a stupid answer.
我可以给一个愚蠢的答案。
When we were young, we used to take drugs.
我们年轻的时候是吸毒的。
And then we'd say, just love everybody.
我们说啊，我们就爱所有的人。
Because the drugs made you feel like you could love everybody.
因为那个药会使你感觉到你好像你爱所有的人。
But when they wore off, it was different.
但是药失效，就是慢慢的这个药效退掉以后，你就感觉比所有人都差。
The answer is, like I was saying before, you have to try to see the good in everyone and love them for what's good about them.
我们一直说，我们需要去看到别人的优点，就因为对方的优点而去爱他。
One of the six offenses to Vaishnavas is to not become joyful upon seeing them. How can we understand this and avoid this offense? He's saying, if you see another devotee and you don't become happy to see them, that's an offense. How can?
在我们对一个外施那瓦来说，如果我们看见一个奉献者，我们不高兴，这其实是一种冒犯。就看不高兴看见某一个奉献者，这其实就是对他是一种冒犯。
It's considered offense. Like if I see you, you come in the door and I go, oh no.
就好像你进来了，我就看见你了，就不喜欢的话，这其实就是一种冒犯。
That's considered an offense.
这会被认为是一种冒犯。
So he's asking how to do that.
那怎么样来解决这个？
I have a mantra.
我有一个曼陀罗。
I love all the devotees.
我爱所有的奉献者。
Even the ones I hate.
即使是那些我恨的人。
You didn't get it? You understand?
你明白吗
？I love all the devotees, even the ones I don't love.
我爱所有的人，就算那些我恨的人，我也是爱他们的。
So I may not like you, but I still love you.
我可能不喜欢你，但是我还是爱你的。
I may not want to live in the same house with you.
我可能不会想和你住在一个房间里。
I may not even want to do service with you.
我可能也不想为你做什么服务。
But I still love you.
但我仍然爱你。
I don't like you, but I love you.
我不喜欢你，但是我爱你。
You understand?
Maybe you have to explain that. 可能要解释一下，我不喜欢你又怎么爱你了
？We hit a blank wall here. Okay. You're a devotee.
你是一个奉献者。
So devotee is the highest.
奉献者是最高的。
So because you're a devotee,
因为你是个奉献者
I love you.
所以我就爱你。
But you don't always act like a devotee.
但是你并不总是做的像一个奉献者一样。
So when you don't act like a devotee, I don't like the things you do.
当你就没有按照一个奉献者的去行为的话，我就不喜欢这个你了。
But because you're a devotee, I love you.
因为你是个奉献者，所以我爱你。
So I love you even though I don't like you. In other words, I love you even though I don't like what you're doing.
就是我爱你，所以即使我不喜欢你所做的事情，但是我是爱你的，因为你是奉献者。
Like your child does something wrong, but you still love the child because he's your child.
就像你的孩子有时候做错了事情，可是你还是爱他的，因为他是你的孩子。
Something like that. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah. I was in America recently for the first time in.Like a year.
我在美国，那么这一年里面第一次。
And I had such a good time.
我感觉到非常开心。
Because I didn't have to explain these things.
因为我不需要解释这些东西。
Because everybody would understand them.
因为每个人都会明白。
When I travel, I don't know always what you'll understand.
可是我当我就在美国的时候，我就知道大家都明白。但是我如果到外地去的话，就大家就不一定明白了，可能有时候要解释一下。
What I said was actually funny.
我所说的其实是很好玩的。
But you didn't get it.
但是你们没有。
But if I said it in America, they would get it.
但你们没有明白，但我如果在美国说的话，大家都会明白，就会有，马上就会有反应。
So this is my austerity in traveling.
这就是我在旅行当中的苦行。Maybe it's my fault. I didn't convey your idea.
Maybe. Yeah. Either way, your fault or it's just not clear. But that's my austerity.
也可能是我翻译的还没有很准确地传达他的想法，所以大家没有马上反应出来。
Sometimes I'll say something that's funny and nobody gets it.
有的时候我会说了一些很好玩的东西，但是没人理解。
Then when I tell them that was supposed to be funny, then they get it.
当我说这应该是很好玩的吧，然后他们就觉得哦好玩。
Yeah. So you have any questions or comments?
你们大家有什么问题或者评论吗？
Yes.
我问你是这样的，就是说内心啊，内心的改变，比如说谦卑和容忍，就是这个内心，从内心发生改变的话，是一个很长的过程，而且是一个不容易的过程。当他讲这个当他讲这两个词的时候，因为我们奉献者接触嘛，也有一段时间嘛，就会想到一个反面的词，就是一种。叫虚伪，虚伪。怎么说这个事情呢？当一个人跟两个人接触的时候，顾内教导我，你要谦卑，你要容忍。所以我对每一个人谦卑容忍。我把这个当成我的座右铭。但是随着时间一长呢，我心里积攒的这个怨恨啊。这个怨气啊就越来越多，可能对方呢也同样，彼此之间的结合啊默契啊就没有像原先那么融洽。有一天终于有一个事情，也许亏杀安排让它爆发出来，爆发出来之后呢就变成了刻薄嫉妒吵架嘛，一些乱七八糟的事情全部说出来了。这是发生，我说这个是发生一个老奉献者和一个年轻的奉献者之间的身上。老奉献照顾这个新的奉献者，新的奉献者就说我是应该的，因为是你是老的照顾我，我就应该是被照顾的。有一天互相这个摩擦越来越多的时候，这个积累就越来越多，终于的爆发了，爆发的刻薄容忍嫉妒猜疑什么都有。然后新的奉献者说了一句话，虚伪，挑头就走了，也跟这个哈利·克里斯塔拜拜，我不修了，因为你给我的就是一个虚伪。我就说这是很漫长的过程，所以说我们当讲容忍和谦卑的时候是很容易的，但是做起来是非常非常难的，因为特别是对中国人来说，可能是要一辈子才去做两做做做做才能做这个这两个这一个词的话，要一辈子才能做得到
修炼，
一辈子才能做得到，因为我们没有参照物，谦卑真正的谦卑我们没有参照物，我们也许在我们的行为上面去规范自己。
你说没有参照物是说没有一个榜样在那里是吗？
对对对，因为我们从小啊没有参照，当然你可以这样说我骨子里啊什么，但是每个人的心里啊都在做比较的，都在做比较的，每个人的心里都在做比较的，所以说这个谦卑对我们来说现实的话，怎样让我们能认识到谦卑容忍这么好的品质，作为外商啊这个品质的话是非常非常难的，所以说当我们一个团队合作的时候，如果大家都能像顾队讲的这个谦卑容忍的话，大家都有这样的这个善行的话，这个合作是很自然的。所以有个调查问卷就说，调查问卷说当你家想雇佣一个佣人的时候，这边是机器人，这边是 人的话，机器人和人两个人价格是一回事，就是比如说都是2000块的话，你想是要机器人还是要人？所有人都问你要机器人，都是要机器人，所以是很难的。
上树也挺
难。但你的问题就是说，怎么样让我们能够做到真正的谦卑和容忍，而不是只是表面的，就是假，就是很虚伪的压抑自己的这些想法。
对，而且我们真正的我们奉献者之间的一些隔阂矛盾啊，都来自于这些，
来自于压抑了你的原本的想法，
哎，
是吗？
压抑奉献者之间这种摩擦的这种释放，因为没有释放，因为我要行为上，刚我们说的行为上，我要谦卑，要友善，
所以说 speak Chinese
就变成了一种压抑。所以总有一个释放的过程。
As you said, we should act not as being hurt, not as upset. We should act in the right way, in the correct way. So, in that case, for most Chinese devotees, they would behave like they are humble, act as they are humble, they are tolerant. But underneath their heart, there's something, you know, stuck there. They cannot expose their real feelings.
Okay.
So over time, they would become hypocritical, especially for Chinese, because many Chinese, they care a lot about their face, you know. Not to lose face, so they will behave like they are humble, and, but in their hearts they're actually not, and they don't have an example to follow.
Very good point. Okay, I understand.
So, that's the question.
So what I meant was, when you act humbly, it's not so you'll get other people to think you're humble, which I think is what you're saying.
You mean when you act humble, you don't want others to think you are humble.
If I act humbly because I truly want to be humble, that's good. If I act what he's saying is you act humbly because you want other people to think you're humble.
Okay. 那其实Guru说的意思呢，是说，当我们要以谦卑的去行动的时候，是我们真正想要谦卑，而不是我们希望别人认为我们是谦卑的。如果你是希望得到别人认可，说哎呦这个人很谦卑，你是为了这样一个目的去表现的谦卑的话，你的内心就会有不平衡。
So you look good where inside you're not cultivating humility, you're just doing it externally to look good.
所以如果你只是说为了得到别人的认可，认为你是谦卑的，你这样去表现的谦卑的话，其实你的内心并没有培养出谦卑的这种品质来。
And then he's sayingBecause we're afraid to be honest about our problems, because then we won't look good and other people will judge us.
就说还有就有的时候我们会不会很诚实的把我们的想法说出来，那是因为什么？你怕别人对你有评判。
Correct.
对吗？
Correct.
怕别人对你有评判，然后你就会感觉不太好，所以有时候你就不愿意把你真实的想法说出来。
I understood. Did I understand?
这一点你能够理解吗？
Yes. Yeah, okay. So, this is not a problem only in China.
这其实并不只是在中国奉献者当中有这样的问题。
Maybe it's also a problem here. Maybe it's bigger here, I don't know. But it's a problem everywhere.
其实这是各个地方都有这样的问题。
If you have a problem,
如果你有一个问题,
and you don't want anybody to know,
你又不想让别人知道,
you know what happens to that problem?
你知道这个问题会怎么样呢?
Gets bigger.
这个问题会变得更大。
Because the way you solve a problem is to bring it out and talk about it.
因为你如果想解决这个问题的话，你就必须要把它拿出来去讨论。
Now the problem is,
而现在问题是，
if we talk about it,
如果我们讨论这个问题，
then we're afraid the person we talk about it with is not going to respect us, and or they'll tell somebody else.
那当我们就是说，如果把这个问题拿出来跟别人去讨论的时候，我们很担心跟我们讨论的这个人他会不会太尊敬我们，可能会因为 你坦白了这个想法之后，别人可能会对你 有什么想法了，或者是你会担心这个人他可能把你跟他说到的这个问题告诉其他的人。
Let's say you go to the doctor.
比如说就像我们去看医生一样。
You have a really bad pain in your knee.
你的这个膝盖有 很瘦很痛。
But you don't tell him.
但你不告诉医生你的膝盖疼。
Because you're afraid he's going to have to replace your knee.
因为你很担心他会把你的膝盖换掉。
So you just don't say anything.
所以你就什么都没说。
And then next year you can't walk.
然后第二年你就走不了路了。
And he could have cured your knee.
本来你是可以把你的膝盖治好的。
You have to tell him.
你必须要告诉他。
So problems are like that.
所以问题也是这样。
You have to talk about them.
你得把这个问题拿出来讨论。
And you keep them to yourself.
如果你只是藏在心里的话。
They get worse and worse.
它就会变得越来越糟糕。
Now I have some good news for you.
我现在有些好有个好消息告诉你们。
Well, it's bad news, but it's good news also.
它是个坏消息，但也是个好消息。
We all have the same problems.
我们都有同样的问题。
We did an exercise sometimes.
有时候我们会做这样的练习。
Where we go around the room.
我们就绕着房间走一圈。
And each devotee tells the devotee they're talking to their problem.
然后呢，就是每个奉献者会告诉他前面的奉献者他们的问题。
And then they ask for advice how to solve the problem.
然后他会问那个奉献者怎么样去解决这个问题，他们有什么建议。
So I come up to you and I say, this is my problem.
就像比如说我走进你了，我跟你说啊，这是我的问题。
Can you help me?
你能不能帮助我？
And then you say, I think you should do this or that.
然后你会说啊，我觉得你应该这样做那样做。
Then you come up to me and say, this is my problem. Can you help me?
然后另外一个你过来跟我说啊，我有个问题，你能不能帮助我？
And then I say I think you should do this or that.
然后我说你应该这样做那样做。
And then we keep going around the room.
然后我们就这样在屋里面这样走。
So let's say there's 20 devotees here, so you would get 20 different devotees giving you the same advice.
所以你就是围着房间有大概有二十个人左右，那么你去跟每一个人去说你的问题，那么你会得到二十个建议。
And you would get 20 different devotees telling you their problems.
也会有二十个奉献者来跟你说他们的问题。
So, this is an amazing, amazing exercise.
这是一个非常非常奇妙的一个练习。
Many levels it helps devotees.
在很多层面上都能够帮助到奉献者。
And one of the things devotees say,
有一件事情奉献者说的是,
practically everyone who came to me to reveal their problem, it was a problem I had myself.
就是每一个来跟我说出他们问题的人，他们说出的问题其实都是我所有的问题。
So the reality is,We may all be pretending to not have any problems when we actually all have the same problems.
所以我们会知道，我们可能每个人都在假装自己没有什么问题，但实际上我们每个人都有这些问题。
And how do I know we all have the same problems? Because we're all conditioned souls, and all the problems of conditioned souls are discussed in our books.
那我们怎么知道所有的人，我们每个人都有所有的问题呢？因为我们都是受限制的灵魂。
And I also have practical experience from counseling that we all have the same problems.
那我当我做咨询的这个经验下来，我也感觉到确实是每个人都有同样的问题。
So, if you're around older devotees and you're pretending, and you're a younger devotee and you're pretending you don't have any problems, they know you're pretending.
当一个年轻的奉献者走到一个年长的奉献者身边，然后这个年轻的奉献者假装他没有什么问题，但是年长的奉献者一看就知道他有什么样的问题。
And the fact is that the more you advance, the more willing you'll be to reveal your problems, because that's the sign of humility.
那么其实是当我们这个奉献者他越是精进，他越是容易把他的问题给说出来，因为这是表现出他的谦卑来。
So what do you want to do? You want to look good, or you want to go back to Godhead?
你是想要看起来好，还是想要回归守身？
You have to decide which is more important.
你要决定哪一个更重要？
Yeah. So.Probably the biggest problem is you tell somebody your problem and they judge you or complain about you or complain about you to other people.
但很大的问题呢，就是当你向别人揭示出你的问题的时候，对方可能会评判你，或者对你有抱怨。 或者会把这个问题告诉其他的人。
Like you reveal something to me.
比如说我把，比如说你把你的什么问题告诉我。
Something very private.
可能是很私密的问题。
Like something really bad.
或者是某些很糟糕的事情。
Like I lost faith in my Prabhupada. I lost faith in Prabhupada.
比如说，哎呀，我对帕布帕德失去信心了。
So what's my natural reaction?
那我的自然的反应会是什么呢？
You're a demon.
哦，你是个恶魔。
Something like that is my reaction, right?
那我的反应可能会是这样。
You're really bad.
你看，真是糟糕，怎么对帕布帕德都没信心啊？
Right.
嗯。
But what she needs is someone to listen who's sympathetic, so she can talk about it.
但是对她来说，她需要的是有一个人来倾听她，能够去理解她，同情她。
Right.She says, I lost my faith in Prabhupada. I'll say, why? Tell me about it. What happened?
那比如说有人来跟你跟我说，哎呀，我对帕布帕德都失去信心了。那我会回答说，为什么呀？发生什么事情了？
I read this thing in his books and I can't accept it. Something like that. So I'm listening.
所以我可能会说，哎呀，我读了帕布帕德的书，有些东西我不能接受，对吧？你就会把你的想法说出来。
And I'm letting her talk.
然后我就会让他一直在讲。
So we're working it out.
然后我们慢慢地找了办法。
But many of us would just shut her up immediately.
但是很多人呢的反应就会是马上让这个人闭住嘴巴，对吧？马上给他一个评判，他就不再讲了。
You're offending Prabhupada.
你在冒犯帕布帕呀。
You can't say that.
你不能这么说呀。
But it doesn't solve the problem.
但这并不能解决问题。
So part of the problem of being able to open up is to have people who you can open up to who won't judge you.
那么所以就是我们到底在多大程度上能够敞开心扉取决于聆听我们的人他到底能够接受我们多少。
So I think some devotees would open up if there were people they could open up to who wouldn't tell anybody and who wouldn't judge them.
所以如果我们去倾诉的对象他能够打开心扉接受我们去倾听我们也不会对我们做出评判也不会把这个我们跟他讲的东西告诉其他的人的话那么我们就会更容易打开心扉了。
So if we want to solve the problem that he's presenting,
所以如果我们想解决他所提出的问题的话
we have to be able to listen without judging.
所以我们那时候就必须要能够去聆听而不带评判。
And we have to stop trying to impress other devotees.
我们也不要老是想着去在奉献者当中留下一个更深刻的印象去打动或去取悦奉献者。
When I say practice humility,
所以要去练习谦卑。
I don't mean fake that you're humble.
而不是说去假装你的谦卑。
It's mean do the practices of it.
所以这就是让我们不断的去练习的真的学会去谦卑。
Cooperate, serve.
去合作呀去服务啊。
Don't advertise yourself as somebody special.
不要这个去为你的某些特长去好像去宣扬你自己。
Those are the practices.
所以这些都是我们所应该去做的练习。
But fake humility is just to show off.
但是如果去假装你的谦卑那只是一种炫耀。
That's just acting.
所以就需要我们去做。
Prabhu.
那只是一种就是像作秀一样。
I'm the most fallen.
我是帕布，我是最堕落的。
You are such a great devotee.
你是这么一个伟大的奉献者。
I am just like a piece of dust at your feet.
我只是你莲花足下的一粒尘土。
And I can't imagine in thousands of lifetimes I'll ever be even a speck of what you are.
我很难想象，我的经过了无数生世，我都还只能是做你这个足下的一粒尘土。
That's false. It's artificial. It doesn't help.
这种话其实是很虚伪很肤浅的。
But there's the desire to be humble.
所以要有这个去谦卑的愿望。
You know, sometimes that very devotee who's saying those things, he can't get along with anybody.
往往是说这样的话的人他和其他的奉献者是没办法就是友好相处的。
So what's the purpose? Going around like this and fighting with everybody.
那当你就是好像看起来很谦卑的去顶拜每个人但是你却在和每个人打架的话那又有什么意义呢你这个顶拜有什么用呢
That's not humility, it's just acting.
那就不是谦卑只是在作秀了。
So you, know, so you can become famous for being humble.
所以你可以
Something like that.
因为你的谦卑而变得出名。
Or become famous for being the most fallen.
或者是 作为一个最堕落的人而谦卑。
Prabhu, I'm the most fallen.
Prabhu, 我是最堕落的。
Oh, you're so humble.
哦，你太谦卑了。
You're such a great devotee.
你真是太这么伟大的一个奉献者。
Yeah, that's what you want to hear.
那是你想听到的，对吧？
So that doesn't help anything.
这对事情没有什么帮助。
But then if everybody does that, you have an unhealthy environment.
如果每个人都是这样虚伪的话，那么这个环境就是不健康的了。
And if everyone's willing to be honest, and everyone who listens to the honesty doesn't judge, then you create a healthy culture where we can work our problems out.
那如果每个人都是很诚实的话，而且每个人又对其他人诚实的想法不做评判的话，
yes?
那么整个这个氛围就是很健康的。
So, I think personally, I think it's part. I don't think it's just a cultural thing. I think it's part of being a devotee that you kind of.You feel like I should be a good example, like I should show that I'm Krishna conscious so everyone will get some inspiration from me.
所以作为一个奉献者，我们不要总是想着，哎呀，我因为我是个奉献者，我应该表现得很多，表现出很多奉献者的品质来，我应该给别人做一个示范。
Or you think I'm Krishna conscious, so I have to play the part.
所以或者是你觉得我是具有 Krishna 知觉的，那我的行动、言行举止上应该表现得有 Krishna 知觉。
I have a story.
我有一个故事跟大家讲。
Beautiful story.
很美的故事。
Yeah, we're getting the icing on this discussion.
What icing?
Icing
on the discussion.
Yeah, icing on the cake.
就像是巧克力上的 ice, 就上面那层那层糖霜一样。
Strawberries on the cake.
Yeah, yeah.
Something like that, the top.
就一个点缀的东西。
The whipped cream? Do you have whipped cream?
Yeah.
So one of our god brothers.
我的一个神兄弟
throughout his devotional life had a problem.
在他整个的这个奉献生活当中都有一个问题。
And he kept it to himself.
然后他一直都把这个问题藏在心里。
But the problem was something that someone in his position isn't supposed to have.
那么这个他的这个问题呢，是在他的这个位置上他不应该有的一个问题。
So he became very sick.
所以他后来就病得很厉害。
And he thought, maybe I'm not going to live that much longer.
他想我可能活不了那么久了。
And he said, I can't die having kept this a secret from all my friends and so forth. I need to tell people that I have this problem because I've been just acting like I'm more advanced than I am.
他说 我也可以就是说把这个秘密带着这个秘密去死掉，那也可以把这个秘密分享出来，那么去帮助更多的人。
So he said, this is quite a high position in ISKCON.
他其实在 ISKCON 当中是占据了一个很高的位置。
And a lot of the God brothers were thinking, you know, people will lose faith in you if you tell them. And now you don't have the problem anymore, so why tell them?
那他的一个神兄弟就说，你如果告诉别人这个事情的话，别人可能会对你失去信心的。反正你现在要死了，你干嘛还要去告诉其他的人呢？
It's like a pass. If the problem's over, so just, you know.
那你就
why ruin everybody's life and tell them what your problem is?
所以干嘛要去破坏了大家的生活，就告诉他们这个问题呢？那他们就会对你没有信心。
And he said, no, I can't die with this.Being a secret that nobody knows, I have to be honest about my condition.
但这个奉献者说，我不能带着这个秘密死掉，我要把这个秘密告诉所有的人。
So he wrote a general letter.
所以他就写了一封信。
Put it on the internet, explaining things he had done that were not proper.
所以他就写了一封公开信，然后把他所做的这种不合适的事情告诉了大家。
Most interesting thing happened.
而最有趣的事情发生了。
Nobody really cared what he did.
但其实没有人在意他做的这个事情。
Because his humility and honesty were so powerful that that's what everybody saw, and they were so happy that he was so honest.
人们呢，其实根本不在意他到底做了些什么，而是看到了他通过他这样就把他的问题揭示给大家，看到了他的谦卑，所以大家都被他的这个谦卑所感染。
Amazingly.Even the Ritviks appreciated it.
甚至连那个 Ritvik 就那个门派的，对吧？就叫就他们 Ritviks 他们都很欣赏这个奉献者。
Ritviks are like against anyone in a high position. And even they appreciated, at least he was honest.
就连那个 Ridvik, 那波人呢，他们都很欣赏他，因为他觉得他很诚实。
So people really appreciate if you're humble enough to be honest.
所以如果你很谦卑，很诚实，那么大家都会很欣赏的。
So we think we have to look good, but if we're honest, we'll have a healthier society.
我们可能会觉得我们需要看起来很好，但是如果我们更谦卑、更诚实的话，那么整个这个世界都会变得更健康。
You know, when you see older devotees,
当我们看到一些年长的奉献者
，you think, oh, they never had any problems.
你会想，哎，他们应该没什么问题哦。
But the reality is that they had many problems, but they tolerated them.
但实际上是他们其实有很多的问题，只是他们在容忍。
Yeah, so that's important.Is that clear? And did that answer your question?
这个解回答了你的问题吗？
谦卑不是示范。
对 ，humility is not an acting.
No. No.
Yeah. He understands that.
That we, you know, another problem is sometimes we don't understand it, so we act in a humble way, thinking it's real.When it's not real, because we don't know what real humility is.
因为有的时候我们其实并不知道真正的谦卑是什么，所以我们说，哎呀，我们要做谦，要表现得很谦卑，但是我们并不知道真正的谦卑到底是什么，所以你其实还是没有真正谦卑。
So we go around touching everyone's feet, and then an hour later arguing with everybody, because we don't know what humility is.
因为我们不知道真正的谦卑是什么，我们会去触摸每个人的莲花足，然后过一会儿又跟他们去争论。
So if we're practicing humility, then we don't argue.
如果我们去练习谦卑的话，我们就不会去跟别人去争论。
For us, touching everyone's feet is not so important, but cooperating, that's how we manifest humility.
所以去触摸每个人的莲花足，这并不是那么重要的。而我们能够大家互相配合，合作很好，这个才是真正重要的东西。去培养我们谦卑的一个练习。
So, if I'm pretending to be humble, it's a problem.
所以如果我们假装谦卑的话，这就是问题了。
I don't like you, but I'll work with you. That's not pretending to be humble, that's acting humbly.
所以如果我不喜欢你，但是我还是会跟你合作，跟你一起来做事。所以这并不是说，这其实就是说，以一种谦卑的方式去行动。
We're different. Some people are different. Some people like one another more, some people like one another less, but still we work together.
我们每个人都会有不同的喜好，对吗？但是我们还是可以一起来合作。
Yes, that's okay. Very good question.
非常好的问题。
我紧接着这个法会的问题，因为刚刚课堂中公主讲过，就是说，当我们没有对别人没有爱、没有谦卑的时候，我们可以通过行动，其实练习自然的会产生这种爱和谦卑。但是现实中是我们这种爱还没有真正的谦卑还没有，我想问的问题，这种行动是不是会产生这个爱和谦卑？有些时候可能会刻板，就是可能会所谓的虚伪。那么但是你刚讲课当中，刚讲课当中，当我们对一个人没有爱的时候，我们去行动去做，自然而然会产生爱。
对，这顾主刚才讲的意思，
刚刚是不是怀疑我们这样做产生不了谦卑？为什么？
所以顾主刚才就说了，你的谦卑不是没有真正理解谦卑的含义，而且你的谦卑是为了给别人看的，对吧？你是为了得到别人的认可，
不是真正谦卑的行动。
对，
是心。
讲的不是说谦卑是爱吧？当我们对一个人没有爱，对父母没有爱的时候，对一个人没爱的时候，我们通过行动能产生爱。
When we don't love any devotee, but we can act like we love them, and then gradually we'll.Cultivate love for them. Is that
yes,
true?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll give you an example.
那我来给你一个例子。
In India, you have marriages, at least traditionally, where the man and woman didn't meet until the wedding day.
那在印度啊，他们的婚姻都是这个，丈夫和妻子都是在结婚之前，他们连见面都没见过的。
So there was no feeling for one another because they never met one another.
So they were not in a relationship, because they had never met one another.
So, For an American, that's very foreign. I don't know about China if you do that, but in America,
在美国这种事情是很很另类的，就是说
very old system.
对，非常古老的，因为美国人都是自由恋爱的，没有说是父母给你找好了，你都从来没见过人就跟他结婚，在美国这是不太非常怪异的。
So for us, first you get to know, and then you have feelings, and if the feelings are good, you get married.
那通常我们的做法是，我们要先见面，对吧？然后有好的感觉了。然后才愿意结婚。
So, one of Prabhupada's disciples, he said he couldn't figure this out. He said, if they don't know one another, can you get married because you don't love them?
所以帕帕德的一个门徒呢就很好奇，说这个印度人他们彼此都没见过，又没有感情，怎么就能结婚呢？他想不明白。
And Prabhupada said, well, the wife is serving the husband is serving the wife. Through that service, they develop love.
帕布哈德就说，丈夫去服务妻子，妻子去服务丈夫，在这个服务的过程当中，他们就慢慢地培养起来。
Isn't that interesting?
好玩吧？
Through serving one another, you develop affection.
通过去服务彼此，你就会发展出一种爱。
So by serving devotee, you'll develop affection.
所以当你服务奉献者，通过服务奉献者，你就能够发展出对他们的爱。
Or appreciation, or respect, something.
或者是你去感激某些事情或者 尊重别人。
And mercy, you get Krishna's mercy if you serve devotees.
通过你去服务 Krishna, 服务奉献者 ,Krishna 会给到你仁慈。
Bhavya Bhagavan Das, I think we answered your question. If not, you can ask what we didn't answer. And I think that's everything. If we keep going, the questions will keep coming. So, should we stop now or what?
大家还有什么问题？你现在明白了？
One more question.
还有
对，我就其实他们两位谈的这个问题。
I'll continue their question.
实际的操作过程，你看那个帕布刚才讲了，那个老的奉献者一直在服务和照顾那个新奉献者，对吧？那新奉献者呢，认为理所当然，然后在服务的也是在服务的过程中，然后他老的心里就不平衡了，你怎么一点感恩的之情都没有，对吧？然后他一直在椰子嘛，然后这个椰子也是刚才就讲的，在行为上表现出来的忍耐跟谦卑，是吗？但是最后呢是爆发了，吵起来了，吵起来，那个新的认为，好，你以前对我的服务都是虚伪，然后一气之下，我不参加你们奎西纳直觉了。你们奎西纳直觉的人都是虚伪。
好，我先把这个例子跟顾客翻译一下。
对，我待会我的问题是在哪里呢？关键哈不是这个例子，对吧？这个例子就是说，你怎么双方怎么展示头，互相的谦卑呢？对吧？怎么展示谦卑？你再教这个老的再谦卑，再椰子。也不下去了，
那就让Guru给出具体的建议，是吧？比如对这样一个例子，一个对年长的奉献者和年轻的奉献者，
对
他们怎么样表现出谦卑来？
怎么做？怎么展示他们的谦卑
？Just now, the Prabhu gave an example. Actually, I didn't got time to translate.
Okay.
He said, for example, two devotees. One is elder. One is young.
Okay.
And the senior devotee has been tolerating and be guiding the new devotee.With a lot of tolerance and humility, be serving, keep serving the young devotee. But the young devotee never show any appreciation. So the senior devotee has been, you know, kind of suppressing his feelings. So one day, over time, the senior devotee exploded and had a fight with the young devotee. And the young devotee said, okay, I will stop.practicing Krishna consciousness. So you are all just pretending all these years. You are pretending to be humble, to be serving me. And now I know your motive. So I was just not believe in this Krishna consciousness.
Wow.
So in this case, what should the senior devotee do as to show he's humble? And what a young devotee do to be humble?
What should the senior devotee do?
Yeah, some practical skills.
Apologize.
对，那么这个对于这个年长的奉献者来说，他应该去道歉。 他应该去道歉。
Apologize for getting upset.
道歉，因为他就生气了嘛，因为他发怒了，他应该向年轻的奉献者去道歉。
Admit that it was wrong.
要承认他做错了。
You know what this young devotee will do when you apologize?
你知道当这个年长的奉献者去道歉了之后，这个年轻的奉献者会怎么做吗？
They'll apologize also.
他也会道歉。
There's a story, which you may know.
可能你们会知道这个故事。
The four Kumaras, they tried to go to Vaikuntha.
那 Kumaras 像四兄弟呢，想去 Vaikuntha.
There are 7 gates into Vaikuntha.
那么他们要通过七道门，对吧？
So they went through 6 gates.
他们经过了六道门之后。
No problem.
六道门都没问题的。
Seventh gate, they had a problem.
那么到七道门的时候有问题了。
What are you doing here? You don't belong here, just little boys.
你们到这来干嘛？你们就是小男孩，你们到这里来干嘛？就那个门童就跟他说了。
And the boy said, "What are you doing here? You're guards. You don't know the rules. Let us in. Everyone else, let us in."
那么库马尔兄四兄弟他们不是长得很小吗？像小男孩一样吗？他就说：“你这个看门人，你算什么呀？你啥也不懂，你让我们进去。
”So they were both saying, "You're not qualified." They said, "No, you're not qualified."
所以他们都在说你这个人没有资格，然后这个人说那个人没有资格，就当然大家都在互相埋怨。
So Lord Vishnu heard this.
然后主 Vishnu 就听到
argument at the gateway.
他们有人在门口这里争论争吵。
And he saw that the four Kumaras were upset with Jaya and Vijaya.
他看到了四 Kumara 四兄弟呢对这个 Jaya 和 Vijaya 生气了。
So actually Lord Vishnu came and apologized on behalf of Jaya and Vijaya because they represent him, and so their mistake is his mistake.
那主 Vishnu 呢其实就跟 Kumara 四兄弟去道歉说那我的门童跟你们发生了争执那就相当于这也是我的错嘛因为门童是我 来负责管理的所以相当于主 Vishnu 就自己来道歉了代表 Jaya 和 Vijaya 向 Kumara 四兄弟去道歉了
And as soon as Lord Vishnu apologized
当主 Vishnu 他道歉了之后
The four Kumaras apologized
那 Kumara 四兄弟马上也道歉了。
And as soon as the four Kumaras apologized, Jaya and Vijaya apologized.
所以 Kumara 四兄弟道歉之后呢 ，Jaya 和 Vijaya 也很快就道歉了。
So chain reaction of apologies.
所以这是这个道歉之间的一个连锁的反应。
So there's a saying.
所以有个说法。
The first person to win an argument is the one who apologizes.
那第一个进入到争论当中的人，就是需要去道歉的人。
We're fighting.
我们在打架。
And then you apologize.
然后你来道歉了。
You win the argument.
那么你就赢了。
That's the real winner.
这是真正的赢家。
Yeah. You like, that's right in the Bhagavatam.
这是在博家梵歌博家瓦坛当中写到的。
One apology created another apology, created another apology.
一个道歉就会产生另外一个道歉，再产生另外一个道歉。
Jaya and Vijaya had already been cursed.
Jaya 和 Vijaya 已经是得到诅咒了。
So it was too late, but the Kumaras apologized.
但是已经太晚了，但是 Kumara 他还是做出了道歉。
But Krishna wanted them to go into the material world, and so it was arranged like that. But still, they all apologized.
当然了，是主 Krishna 有安排，对吧？想让 Vijaya 和 Vijaya 到这个物质世界来。但即使是这样 ，Kumara 四兄弟还是道歉了。
Good story.
很好的故事吧。
Did you know that?
你们知道这个故事。
Now I want to tell you an amazing story.
那下面我告诉，再给大家讲一个非常美妙的故事。
You know, we're talking about don't act, don't be upset.
我们讲到了不要去生气，对吧
？You know, Ambarish Maharaj.
Ambarish Maharaj.
Durvasa tried to kill him.
Durvasa Muni 呢想去杀死他。
Because he drank some water before he fed Durvasa.
因为他是呢，就是在。喝了一些水就没有先喂给先给到杜尔萨他自己先喝了。
Let's say you invite me over to your house.
假如说你请我到你家里。
You've laid breakfast out.
然后你把这个早餐都摆出来了。
I'm saying, Shri-ra-ra-vijaya.
然后我就在念祷文了。
And while I'm doing that, you drink some water.
当我在念祷文的时候你喝了一点水。
Immediately I pick up a knife and run after you. How dare you eat before me and I try to kill you.
那我马上就拿起一把刀追着你说我还 没吃呢你怎么就先喝了
How would you feel about me?
那你会对我有什么看法呀
Not too good, right?
不太好哈
So, let's say Krishna protected you.
假如说 Krishna 保护你
Somehow, you know, the Sudarshan came and Krishna protected you, and I said I'm sorry.
然后，假如说这个时候，Krishna 来了，带着他的神碟来，他要保护你。然后我说对不起，我来道歉。
You probably say that's all right. Could you just get out of my house right now. Forget the breakfast.
那你可能会说
，I'm too upset to deal with this.
那你可能会已经很生气了，也不想再说这个事情。说那好吧，请你离开我家吧。我本来是你，那就是我请来的客人嘛，要拿刀来杀我，对吧？那我现在也不想再跟你争辩了，你走吧，对吧
？Could you serve breakfast to someone who just tried to kill you 5 minutes ago？
你能够就是一个人五分钟前还要杀你的话，你会愿意给他准备晚早餐吗？
That'd be pretty,
愿意服务他早餐吗
？Pretty difficult, yes。
对吧？这是很难的，是吧
？Ambarish was said, no problem。
但是 Ambarish 说没问题。
Let's have breakfast。
那我们来一起吃早餐吧。
That's amazing, isn't it?That's a pure devotee.
这才是一个纯粹奉献者的做法。
That's our goal.
这是我们的目标。
Sometime or other that we can have no hatred towards anyone.
也许在某一天，我们对任何人都没有仇恨了。
Only love.
只有爱。
Only compassion.
只有同情和怜悯。
That's the goal.
这就是我们的目标。
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Srila Prabhupada ki
jai.
Om Premanandi Hare
Hare. Hare Hare Bol.
Okay, we're going to stop here. It is in 7 hours, everyone, I'm giving class on Facebook in English. Yeah, it's just going to be in English. But you don't have Facebook here, so you can't watch it. Well, he can help you get Facebook. They have secret. So if you're watching, you want to, we're doing class tonight on self-love and self-envy at 8:30. I guess, I don't know, if anybody's here at 8:30, you can attend, but I'm just doing it online.
Okay.
It'll be in English. It won't be translated.
No translation. No.
If you want to come here and you know English, that's okay. Or you want to learn English?
Okay, on Facebook. That Guru, actually, in 7 hours after that,还要在他的 Facebook 上做一个演讲，就关于 self
envy and self love，
就嫉妒、自我嫉妒和自我 self love means love yourself，、
mm-hmm.
envy yourself，
yeah,
envy yourself，
self， how you can be envious of yourself and how you can love yourself。
Okay, 就是怎么样能够去爱自己 ，not envious of yourself.
Yeah, yeah. No,
怎么样 envious of yourself?
Yeah.
怎么样去嫉妒自己？怎么样爱自己？嫉妒自己，可能话题呢有点难理解。
No, now you want me to explain that, right?
你们可能需要我来解释一下，是吧？怎么样嫉妒自己
？Prabhupada said, anytime you do anything to harm yourself, it means you're envious of yourself.
Prabhupada 曾经说。不管什么时候你做了伤害你自己的事情，那么你都是在嫉妒你自己。
So if I do something that's not good for my Krishna consciousness, that means I'm envious of myself.
所以如果我做了什么事情对我的 Krishna 知觉有害的话，那么都是在嫉妒我自己。是这个意思。
So we talk about that.
所以我们八点半的时候
Somebody wants to, we've done about 15 classes. Someone wants to translate them into.Into Chinese, they're really good classes. Yeah, very good classes.
我们已经讲了十五课了。如果有人愿意把它翻译成中文的话，那是非常好的讲课。
And today, you'll be the first to get this book.
今天呢，你们会是第一个得到这本书的。
Yes. This is inaugural. You'll be the first to buy the book. I don't know how much it costs. How much is it?
48.
And if you want to buy more to give your friends or to distribute, that's good also. Maybe some